It is my privilege to welcome you to the graduation ceremony of the class of 2021. We have seen you grow into fine young men and women, and I'm proud to send you out into the world as ambassadors of the Norwegian International School. Over these years, we have joined in your moments of happiness, celebrated your achievements, and comforted you when you were in despair. Our journey has been long and steep, but together we are here today. It's a very special year, 2021, as many countries were hit by the second wave of COVID-19. Here in Nigeria, we were privileged to be able to take the Cambridge IGCSEs and be assembled here in this hall today as we celebrate this remarkable moment of your lives. Today is a very special day for our graduates. I've taken some time to think about what I should share with you this morning. What words of wisdom could I possibly impart? Over these years, you've heard speeches about graduation not being the end, but the beginning. Over these years, I have shared inspiring and meaningful life lessons as part of my speeches. But this morning, I chose an immortal classic, a poem by Rudyard Kipling called If. This poem was awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature. Rudyard Kipling's poem, If, lists a set of conditions for a speaker's son to follow in order to become an ideal man. The speaker advises his son about how to perceive the world and life's challenges so you can earn and learn from the experiences and come over the barriers. It is a set of immortal advices given to the next generation to succeed in life. And this is how it goes. If you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs and blaming it on you. If you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowance for their doubting too. If you can wait and not be tired of waiting, or being lied about, don't deal in lies. Or being hated, don't give way to hating. And yet, don't look too good, nor talk too wise. If you can dream and not make dreams your master, if you can think and not make thoughts your aim, if you can meet with triumph and disaster and treat those two imposters just the same, if you can bear to hear the truth you've spoken, twisted by knaves to make a fool for traps, or watch the things you've given your life to broken, and stoop and build them up with worn-out tools. If you can make a heap of all your winnings, and risk it all on one turn of pitch and toss, and lose and start again at your beginnings, and never breathe a word about your loss. If you can force your heart and nerve and sinew to serve your turn long after they've gone. And so hold on when there's nothing in you except the will that says hold on. If you can talk with crowds and keep your virtue, or walk with kings nor lose the common touch. If neither foes nor loving friends can hurt you, if all men count with you, but none too much. If you can fill the unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of distance run, yours is the earth and everything that's in it, and which is more, you'll be a man, my son. This exceptional classic is a reminder for you to reflect on the words of the poet as you journey through life. I will share a copy of this poem with each and every one of you as a memory of this remarkable day we celebrate. Today is the day we thank the board for their outstanding support to the exceptional educational program that we impart at the Norwegian International School. I thank the academic and the administrative heads of department for all their commitment throughout the year, the school management team for brilliant organization, and the boarding staff for the dedication towards the students. Thank you all the students for making this a successful year. The students performed well in many academic, sporting, and co-curricular events and made the school proud. Our IGCSE and checkpoint scores for 2020 were very impressive. Today is the final opportunity for you to appreciate your parents at this moment. The school management, your wonderful teachers, the boarding staff, each one of you has been guided and shaped by these individuals. It's an exceptionally proud moment for the parents to see the fruit of their commitment and hard work. I take this opportunity to congratulate the parents of each graduate. And to conclude, let me leave you with these words. Success isn't owned, it's leased, and the rent is due to be paid each day. Thank you very much, and God bless.
Good morning, everyone. All right, it's amazing to see these happy faces here today. We will be going right into the teacher commendations for these lovely ones. And to give the commendations for our very own head boy, Chim Din Du, Chidia Valley. I'll be calling on the secondary school coordinator, Mr. Chuks Anointed.
Good morning once again, all protocol duly observed. It is with ample joy that I give commendation to a student who has metamorphosed from good to better, better to best, and best to glory in diligence, knowledge, and character since joining the NIS family 3 years ago. Jim Dindo is a reflective, engaged, innovative, and confident learner who provides detailed responses to questions. His enthusiasm and reflective approach to learning makes it easier for him to conquer most tough topics in mathematics. Jim Dindo always strives to improve on his last performance at any course within his powers. He will always ask for extra tutoring during the long break to understand concepts that are abstract to him. That commitment improved his mock 2 results positively, and I'm convinced his IGCSE results will amaze everyone. Chimdi is an excellent footballer. He does not just play football, he plays football with swag and brilliant skills that keeps his audience fully entertained. He participated in the median edition of the NIS football tournament and was adjudged one of the best strikers. He is also a member of the school's band, an excellent swimmer, and also very good at track events. Chimdi is selfless, sociable, tolerant, and a good team player. A friend to most younger students, he's always ready and willing to sacrifice his happiness for others to be happy. Indeed, he is a people's person. Chimdi, as you take a step further from high school to pursuing your dream to becoming a petroleum engineer, I want you to know that whatever got you to where you are today is not enough to take you to where you are going to. You must do more to become more. If you play today, you will pay tomorrow. And if you pay today, you will play tomorrow. Finally, get a mentor. Put yourself under daily productive routine. Stay focused and keep progressive association.
Eduvier is receptive, very friendly, and easily forgave his friends when offended. His love for football and programming had no bounds as he always showcased his skills in these hobbies at his leisure and extracurricular activities. Therefore, there is no doubt in saying that NIS has actually passed through him just as he has passed through NIS. I have no doubt in my mind by his antecedents that Eduvier will continue to do better, and in fact the sky will be his limit, or rather we'll say his stepping stone, if he lives here to join the macro society. And by so doing, I believe he will be a proud ambassador of NIS. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Eduvier Ogene Onyedikachi, year 11 graduate of NIS class of 2021. Thank you.
Before I call up the next person, I think I need to cough and clear my throat. Pardon me. Okay, next up is our student life prefect. He said I should call him social prefect. The very Xavier Nemi Lawrence. And to give his commendations, we have none other than Mr. Ubi.
The chairman, I don't know if there's any chairman of this occasion, but I know we have the chairman, NIS Board of Governors, the governing board, the school management team, the academic leadership team, fellow teachers and staff members, students, NIS families here present, ladies and gentlemen. Standing beside me is Master Xavier Nemi Lawrence, a proud product of Norwegian International School. It is the culture of NIS to help each student discover themselves. And that is what we have done. We have helped Xavier to discover himself in NIS. From Okrika in River State, I'm born in Bath, United Kingdom, on the 22nd of January. Xavier joined this great school on the 7th of September, 2015. He came in as a year six student. He wants to be an aeronautic or petroleum engineer, and that we wish him well. His 6 years journey in NIS was not a walk in the park. He had his challenges on which he took a nimble ride to victory. There were days, several days, when the food vendor would deliver his lunch late at school. At such times, Xavier learned to become a man who could survive hunger at times. As a true son of the Nemi Foundation, he believes that a man is not made by what life throws at you, but what he makes of himself. He was made to attend 9 classes in a day, being in this hall too many times to count for various activities. He was made to sit in the library to read for many boring hours, as the students call it. He spent numerous hours on the sports facility. He likes games, likes horse riding, likes swimming. Sports time was usually his favorite. All these and more made Xavier the young man you now see. What puts him on is the desire to make people around him happy. That's what turns him on. He rose to the post of the social prefect of NIS. He had many awards to his credit. In year 10, he became the band major one in the music department. He is a decorated sportsman with many medals. In the history of sports in NIS, Xavier, I can say, is one of the finest. His philosophy in life is that if one wants to succeed in life, you have to bring the right people around you, people that know and understand your worth. When he came to me to give a recommendation in his honor, it took me time to decide, because I was wondering why it would be me, because we are always fighting in the corridor, in classrooms, and he hates me being on his neck. But today, I'm not here to scold him or to push him towards the right direction. Just as a student, I have many counsels to give to him. Know your fear and follow your fear until you overcome it. Think of your experience in NIS as a ticket to change the world. Know that all we did here was a dress rehearsal for the life that you will lead yourself. In the words of Henry Peter Broham, education makes a people very easy to govern, but impossible to enslave. As you embark on your higher academic pursuits, remember
do not be enslaved or overtaken by the vices and temptations that bedevil young people in your category. Keep raising the bar for yourself. Banish every darkness with light. Buy the truth and sell it not. Focus your internal GPS to what brings out the best in you so that you can be the best wherever you go. Use the TV and the internet to achieve your purpose. Do not let them use you. There are far better things ahead to achieve, but remember, you have the potential to move mountains and make God, your family, and NIS proud. Lastly, as you leave this place today, don't forget that NIS gives you a stage, a platform on which you can express yourself in the best possible ways. Farewell, Xavier. We love and will miss you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Obi. Congratulations again, Xavier. Okay, moving on in our program. As we all know, goodbyes are one of the saddest words we have to say. Except if it's at the airport and you're saying goodbye to Nigeria, finally. It's just a joke. But really, you know, it makes us feel down and sad each time we have to look at someone and say goodbye. But something that keeps us going is the memories we make, the memories we have of them. So this morning, I'll be inviting the school choir to sing a song titled, I Will Always Remember. In memory of this ones we are saying goodbye to today. The school choir, please, and Miss Oluchi, our coordinator.
Always knew after all these years, there'll be laughter, there'll be tears, but never thought I'd walk away. There's so much joy, but so much pain. So hard to say goodbye.
The times that we had, I'll keep like the food.
graduating students, the choir is saying that you should have high hopes for a living. That wherever what you want is in the world, you can get it and you can get there. Thank you, NIS Choir. Want to continue with the teacher's commendations? We'll call on Mr. Chooks to speak for Jemima Gill. Put your hands together for them as you come.
Still maintaining the existing protocol, it's with great pleasure that I give commendation to a meticulous, self-motivated, diligent, disciplined, dedicated, respectful, and teachable student, Jemima Anege. I have known Jemima for the past 3 years, as she has taken the subjects that I teach, mathematics and physics. I've had the opportunity to observe her participation and interaction in and out of class, and my evaluation of her is very good. Jemima is a complete Cambridge learner who turns in good work and participates actively in all class activities and discussion. She works very well when given the opportunity to take responsibility for her learning. Jemima has proven that through hard work, follow through, and teamwork, she can accomplish tasks in a timely manner. She is aware of her strengths and areas of improvement and responds positively to constructive feedback. Jemima has an excellent presentation skill that keeps her audience in awe whenever she has the opportunity to anchor a school event. She is a member of the school's band, an excellent dancer, and a fashionista. She is the head girl of the school, and she's the head girl of the school for the 2020-2021 academic session. Jemima is an international-minded student whose behavior has never been a concern to the Norwegian International School. She is sociable, tolerant, kind, and a good team player. Jemima, as you graduate from high school to college today, I want you to know that the distinguishing characteristics of leaders is intensity of purpose. Leaders concentrate single-mindedly on one thing, the most important thing, and they stay on it until it's complete. Keep your priorities straight. Avoid the trap of social media. You can become the next Dr. Pimple Popper. It's in you. Go for it. We are waiting to hear of your positive stories. Congratulations.
Is that how you clap? This is lovely.
Thank you, Mr. Chooks, and I want to concur that all the things you've said were not lies. Congratulations, Jemima. Put your hands together for the head girl of Norwegian International School. Thank you. So we'll call on Mr. Ben Oko to speak for Amina Ahmed. Please, let's put our hands together for Mr. Ben.
I am Ben, Mr. Ben Omonu, chemistry teacher and instructor to the class graduating today. I feel very honored. I feel privileged. I'm actually humbled to be allowed this opportunity to make verbal commendations for one of NIS's most extraordinary, one of NIS's most outstanding, one of NIS's most iconic and most prominent student figure in the graduating class. Ladies and gentlemen, join me as I welcome to this podium Amina Ahmed Musa. Standing before us here is a young lady who have had the privilege to instruct, to groom, to nurture in the knowledge of the sciences since her year 8 class. During her time here at the Norwegian International School, Amina Ahmed Musa displayed unparalleled commitment. She displayed tenacity. She actually displayed resilience in the course of her academic odyssey here at the Norwegian International School. Her areas of strength are in the sciences and in the languages. Outside of her classroom, Amina displays amiable leadership qualities. She is the Norwegian International School Student Life Prefect Female for the 2020-2021 academic year. A lover of badminton, she was the deputy house captain for the great Nelson Madiba Mandela House. Character, they say, is the greatest and most powerful motive force in the universe. In its noblest embodiment, it exemplifies the very nature of man. It exhibits the very best of man, in the words of Samuel Smiles. And Amina Ahmed Musa, in all of my years and experience here, I would be indebted to conscience if I do not or read publicly that in all my years and service to the noble institution, the Norwegian International School, Amina happens to be arguably the most modest, simplest, kind-hearted, appreciative, and of course, good-spirited student I've ever had to work with. Amina Ahmed Musa, I appreciate and I'm inspired by your originality. I am inspired by your simplicity, your modesty. I'm honestly inspired by your respect for tradition. And let me say today, at this juncture, that I would like to appreciate her parents, Mr. and Mrs. Ahmed Musa, for raising in this 21st century a child who has respect for tradition, a child who is so modest and simple, a child who, even in the midst of abundance, chooses to be as simple as possible. I congratulate you, sir. I congratulate you, ma'am. I appreciate both of you. Amina, as you move ahead in life to pursue your career in the medicals, I have no doubt, no iota of doubt in me, that you will succeed. Reason is because, first of all, you're driven by conscience, you're driven by your love for people, you're driven by your passion. And I want to tell you, Amina, that the sky is not even your limit. I congratulate you, and I tell you, on behalf of the Norwegian International School, that you have come this far. You did not get this far by luck. Luck doesn't bring you this far. You've gotten to where you are today, this milestone, because you're consistent, you're perseverant, and you're diligent. As you go ahead, on behalf of the Norwegian International School, I am proud of you. We are all proud of you. Reason is, first of all, you made your alma mater proud. And I ask and pray that as you move ahead, that God continues to shine his light upon you and to give you everything you so desire. Once again, I congratulate you, Amina, on this notable milestone in your life. Congratulations, and thank you.
Put your hands together again.
Because Amina is a student that will tell you sorry, even if she's right. That's the kind of student. Very loving. I think all the students, none of them can say that they ever had a truce or any problem with Amina, or they had a disappointment from her. Let's put our hands together again for Amina. Thank you.
We'd like to call on Mr. Eliezer Itiosa.
Good afternoon to the members of Board of Governors, NIS management, parents, and students. My name is Eliezer, one of the music teachers in the school. It is an honor and privilege to give this commendation speech in honor of Oreoluwa Oyetunde. Today, history has been made as Oreoluwa is the first IGCSE music graduate since the inception of the school. Please celebrate. You can do better than that. You can do better than that. Thank you. I'll never forget the first time of meeting Oreoluwa. It was sometime in January 2020. He had followed his mom to pick up his younger sister from the music club in the music room. At this time, he was not yet a student of the school. That day, he performed a musical piece, Canon in D, on the piano. I was thrilled by his performance and wished to be his teacher. Faithfully, my prayers were answered as he joined the school in the following academic year. Oreoluwa has contributed immensely to the growth and strength of the music department. Among his numerous contributions is the accompaniment of the school song and the Nigerian national anthem on the piano at our regular Fridays assembly. He has also helped in my professional journey, as he's the first student I presented for IGCSE music. This made me make more research on the IGCSE music syllabus. Ore, in the Yoruba language, translates friend. Ore is not just a student, but a friend. He possesses great leadership skill, which led to his nomination and election as the house captain of Churchy House by his house members. He will be greatly missed by the music department for his enormous contributions and support. As you move on to higher institution, or in pursuit of your dreams, remain focused, determined and strong to face every challenge of life, knowing that you have all it takes to be successful. I leave you with this quote: for a mind that knows is a mind that is truly free. Remember, life is musical and has various rhythm, sometimes simple. Enjoy it. Sometimes complex. Embrace it. Thank you.
Thank you. Can we clap again? We're supposed to have the student speeches now, but would like to have a solo from Oreoluwa before we start the student speeches. So welcome, Oreoluwa.
for him. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
So we are going to have the students' speeches now, and we'll go in that order. The order they are seated. We have Master Chimdi, Jemima, Master Iduvie, Master Xavier, Amina, and Ore. So they will tell us a little about what they think of today. Yes. I'll call on Mr. Chimdi to come give his speech. Let's put our hands together for NIS Head Boy 2020 to stroke 2021. Put your hands together for him. He likes clapping. He likes people clapping for him. Yes. We celebrate you, Mr. Chimdi.
Wow. Wow. It's actually the day. Good day to the board of directors, the parents, the teachers, and the students. This is the day that has a positive and negative side. Positive is I finished secondary school, as you all know, and negative is I'm leaving you all. NIS has been a nice family to have. I've been part of this family ever since I was in year 9, and I regret being in here in year 9. I wish I was here since year 7. There are so many things to love about this NIS family. I'm so grateful to have been a part of this family. I would miss being welcomed to school by the reception, then having fun with friends before the classes of the day. I loved scoring teachers every time we met them in teachers versus students. And I also love the intensity of second break football. I'll miss all the countless jokes that I shared and were shared with me, including Mr. Chuksi's names, compound interest, Mr. Obi's hailings when I come to school, and Mr. Ben's competitions with me for chemistry. I miss all the times I also had with students, the jokes, the fun, and our games together. I would like to thank my parents for enrolling me into NIS and also being there for me every time I needed them the most. I also like to thank my aunt, Mrs. Udensi, for being there always and cheering me up when I wasn't in honor roll in year 9. I would like to thank my classmates for accommodating my excesses, knowing it was a lot. I would like to thank my teachers that made me love their subjects that I learned and pushed me to become the best I can academically. I also like to thank the staff who aren't here with us anymore, including late Mr. Bright. I would like to thank the music staff for making good performances during our Friday assemblies, including the band and the other team. And I obviously love to thank Founders House for accommodating me ever since I was in year 9. I'd love to thank the staff, Ms. Gifty, Mr. Stanley, Ms. Oluchi, the nurses. Yeah, that's all. And I also love to thank the students that have always been here to have fun with me, even when there was no time for fun. And even when we could not have fun, there was fun in not having fun. I would also like to thank the Board of Management of NIS for making NIS a worthy school to attend. I can't also forget to thank the cleaners for making me have a very conducive environment, and the security personnel for keeping the school safe day and night. Lastly, I will thank all the students in NIS for being a fun set of children
and friends. Since the world is a small place, I know we will see again at some point. Therefore, I will say goodbyes for now. See you at the top. Thank you.
That was lovely. That was lovely. There was fun in everything. In NIS, we make fun of everything. Whether you're learning, you're happy or not happy, we try to make fun of everything. Thank you, Mr. Chimdi. Call on Jemima Gill to give her speech. Put your hands together for Jemima.
Good afternoon, ladies, gentlemen, parents, members of the board of directors, management, teachers, staff, and my fellow students. It's an honor and a privilege to be standing here this morning sharing my message with you. It has been a very fascinating and memorable educational journey for me in Nigeria. I've spent 13 years of my school life in Nigeria. I began my elementary education at the American Elementary School. I did my middle school at a British school, and finally being able to graduate from a secondary school called the Norwegian International School, where I've spent the last 3 academic years. My time at NIS has been most rewarding. Over these years, I've grown academically, matured socially, and developed my leadership skills as the head girl for the 2021 academic session. I would like to take this opportunity to thank all the teachers who have been my guides and mentors during my time here. I appreciate your never-ending support and never-ending patience in taking time to explain academic concerns that I presented. A few of my most memorable moments at NIS was being able to show my artistic talent by designing the Sports Day logo for 2 consecutive years. And I felt really happy to see everyone wearing my little design on their housewares. I will also remember every activity or moment that I spent with my classmates, cherishing every laugh, like during classes, activities in school, sports, or any photo sessions that we would have in the middle of the day because of our love for taking pictures, and later being able to laugh and remember all these moments through the help of our photographs. I was also one of the drummers for the NIS band, and I got to play a drum bigger than me. The bass. It will definitely be something I remember because of how huge it was and how heavy it was to the point where it covered my face most of the time. With that, I would like to say thank you to the music department for their support and giving me the opportunity to embrace my musical side. NIS is a small, loving community. We bond with our primary pupils as much as we bond with our secondary fellow students. I have made some memorable friends at NIS with whom I've spent some quality time. I see myself as a people's person, and it was very easy for me to work with my fellow students. Today is a day that celebrates me just as much as it celebrates my fellow classmates. We've stuck by each other's side these years through thick and thin, and I'm very proud I get to share the stage with them and no one else because we've grown amazingly close, and I love everything about every one of my classmates. I would like to appreciate the board of directors for providing us such an outstanding educational experience at NIS. The Norwegian International School is a beacon of excellence with high standards of student achievement in Nigeria, and it's an honor to graduate from such a very remarkable institution. I need to take the moment to appreciate God for showing me this milestone in my life and my parents for their never-ending support. Thank you to the management, admin crew, and the support staff for their commitment towards the educational program. In addition, a final appreciation for Mr. Chooks, our class teacher, for being there for us when we needed him. He will always be remembered for his jovial mannerisms when dealing with stress we presented him with. He has been kind, generous, supportive throughout the year, and we will always remember his contributions in our lives. I look forward to pursuing a career in the field of medicine, probably dermatology, so I might be the next Dr. Pimple Pop. Let's see. To conclude, I congratulate my fellow graduates, and I hope to see each and every one of you graduate from the Norwegian International School with strong foundations of diligence, knowledge, and character. Thank you so much for listening.
You can still clap. Yes, we also thank you, Jemima, for all your laughter and several greetings. Jemima will greet you 100 times in one day. Let's put our hands together for Jemima. Thank you. Thank you. We have Eduvie Ogene to give his speech. Put your hands together for Eduvie.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to thank my parents, my teachers, and my friends for helping me throughout my time in NIS. My greatest thanks, however, goes to God for his faithfulness and abundant grace for my time here. I will really miss the soccer league. It's one of my best memories of NIS. You know, it's amazing how much we have all changed in the last 3 years. At my first day here at NIS, I could barely reach the locker or talk to anyone. But now I'm glad to report that I can reach my locker and socialize better. For the students behind me, someday it'll be your turn to stand up here. Just remain focused. Thank you.
You're not clapping.
Eduvie is an interesting student, but not a man of many words. Let's put our hands together for him again. I'm going to miss all of you. Okay, we'll call on Xavier to give his speech.
Good day, ladies and gentlemen, teachers, administrators, parents, friends. Welcome. We are graduating. Can you believe it? A few years ago, most of us walked into this hall as nervous as we were the first day of school. We were in the lower stage, the low secondary. Now, a few years after, we are leaving the school behind to a whole new crop of people, most of whom were just as nervous as we were when we arrived. It has been long 6 years and short for me, long because of all the drama, plenty homework I get every day from teachers, the boring readings and early morning lineups. Some days I just don't feel like coming to school. And all the other little blunder that hit us in secondary school. Short because of the lifelong friendship, the lasting memories, and the truly interesting and amazing things we learned over the years. Good or bad, long or short, I will always remember this place. While I was thrilled to be an outgoing social prefect, I can't say I've spent as many hours as some of us have in this halls. Our teachers, of course, spend more amount of hours time here, and students do as well. Most of them even do it of their own choosing that's been dedicated, and I'm so glad I have such amazing teachers. It takes that kind of teamwork to survive anywhere I found. I know my experience is limited, but every problem I've overcome has become because someone was there to help me. That someone is the head boy of the school. His name is Chimdi. Also known as compound interest. Other supports come from the rest of my friends. Palel, Oreo, number one pianist in the school, Kazman, Jemski, Mina, Nora, Gabby, my year 10 G's, the ones I call the senior men of the school, the wonderful WHUD, William, Hans, Oche, and Divine. Everybody knows me in NIS as someone who looks for trouble and a strong vibe. Without me being in school, it's like a school building without students. No joke. There's one woman who has disturbed my life the most in this school. We all know her, the one and only Miss Bucci. There's no day I come to school without her shouting at me, but that didn't stop me from coming anyways. She only made me stronger. What's next? I'll be going to college, as will many of my classmates. More of us will go to various branches of the world to further their educations. Leaving high school is such a brutal transition. As my late grandma would say, you don't know what the world has in store for us. For any of us, take your education very seriously. There's one thing about NIS I really love. It's not only to sit you down in class, but teachers groom us for the outside world. And I've gotten plenty of people to thank for. My parents, of course, teachers, friends, and God. I guess that means the biggest thing I've learned in secondary school is to meet others for help when in trouble. There's another more important side to that idea as well. It's the one piece of advice I would like to give my fellow students and graduates. As we get ready to cross this stage for the last time, make sure you are around people who are real, not fake friends, that only want to talk to you when they are in need for something. Congratulations, class of 21. We made it.
Thank you, Xavier. We'll call on Amina Med to give her speech.
Good morning to our parents, teachers, and friends, and the staff of NIS. First of all, I would like to say that I am much honored to have given the opportunity to present the speech. Wow, we are finally graduating. Thank you to everyone present here. Thank you to everyone who is part of the school. Thank you to our teachers, parents, families, and friends. As students and friends, we have made many memories together, many good and some bad, most of which we can now look back to and laugh. I still remember my first day at NIS as a student in year 6. Ms. Nkechi was the first teacher who taught me here, and the subject was maths. And the last teacher who taught me here was Mr. Ben, and the subject was chemistry. It was then in year 6 I made my first set of friends. Years passed, and I was in all the classes from year 6 to 11. It was here at NIS that I made the most memories from events like family fun day, class parties, student versus teachers football match, Easter egg hunts, and much more. Thanks to NIS, I was able to have a work experience in the field I wanted to study, and I think it was one of the best things I experienced here in NIS. And also the time when professionals in their fields came to our school to talk about their professions. I also had the privilege of being part of the student leadership. I always had fun when events like this happened here at NIS. In year 11, we had our ups and down moments with our teachers, but they still helped us go through it all. We had classes upon classes in school and much more on Zoom, especially with Mr. Ben, and I am forever grateful for that. I will also miss the times whenever we're done for IGCSE papers for the day, we would go to staff room to have a chat with the teachers. Like Mr. Ben would say, you don't know how far you've gone until you look back. Today, NIS is celebrating us, and our old classmates are here to celebrate with us, especially PA, Adama, and David, who left in year 11 before we wrote our exams. But I know they're doing well wherever they are. To my dear teachers, Mr. Ubi, Mr. Chooks, Mr. Ben, Mr. Greg, Mr. Ifeanyi, Mr. Chiu, Mr. Anthony, Mr. Maxwell, and Ms. Ifeanyi, thank you for your support. I am forever grateful to you. To my fellow graduates, I'll miss you just as much and wish you all the best in your future endeavors. We promise to make NIS proud as well. Thank you and congratulations, class of 2020.
Thank you, Amina. Thank you. We call on Ore Olua to give us his speech. You are not clapping.
Good afternoon, Board of Governors, parents, teachers, and my fellow students. Thank you all for giving me this wonderful opportunity to speak today. In 2020, humankind faced a global threat like no other. Because of the COVID-19 pandemic, schools were shut and many students were probably bored to their deaths during the lockdown. Schools couldn't end the sessions properly, and people across the globe wondered whether we were ever going to see light on the other side. Today, that light has shone on me and my fellow classmates, as we have not only conquered the stress battles of IGCSE examinations, but we are finally able to celebrate our progress in the indescribably bittersweet game called reality. The clock is ticking, it always has. As the time clocks, excitement fills the vicinity, because once the event is over, history would reckon that my classmates and I became graduates of Norwegian International School. My name is Oreluwa Yetunde, a student of NIS class of 2021, and it will be a great honor to proceed with my graduation speech. First and foremost, I would like to give all thanks to the Almighty God for making me progress all the way from 7th grade to my final year in secondary school. I would like to thank my parents for painstakingly helping me during pleasant and definitely tough times in school. I would like to also give gratitude to my little sister, Ireluwa, for always being by my side in NIS. My seemingly awkward life in school wouldn't have been interesting and competitive without my wonderful comrade, Amina, and her unrivaled passion, Chimdi and his exceptional talent, Jemima and her wonderful leadership skills, Xavier and his drip, Eduvi and his world-class football skills, and the likes of Priye, Adomo, and David, who were once with us during our journey, but found other opportunities to learn. I would like to thank all the teachers, including Ms. Linda, the librarian, Mr. Ben, my chemistry teacher, Mr. Paul, Ms. Tunu, Mr. Greg, Mr. Ifai, Mr. Anthony, Mr. Obi, Ms. Ifai, and other teaching staff members that aided me when I was writing IGCSE, especially my homeroom teacher, Mr. Chooks, who has been constantly motivating me and my classmates to work harder towards our desired academic goals every single second of our time in class. The most amazing times of my life in Norwegian all lied in the music room. Ever since I was little, I had passion for music, and I would like to thank Norwegian International School for not letting that kindled passion of mine go to waste. I became NIS first IGCSE music candidate, and handling the pressure wasn't as easy as anticipated. I would like to thank Mr. Eliezer, who was my IGCSE music teacher, and Mr. Ni, for encouraging me to put in my best when I'm playing piano. I would like to thank them for helping me during the course of not only the IGCSE music examination, but also the Victoria College of Music examination that I successfully wrote earlier this year. However, I wouldn't have been able to successfully finish and submit the IGCSE music examinations, particularly the performing paper, if not for Yembe Toyela and her family. Thank you so much for sacrificing your time to assist me with my exam. I would love to give my thanks to Chimdi, Tammy, Lashmi, Kazi, Dazi, Hemen, an exceptional musical prodigy, Chika and Xavier, for playing various instruments with me during the school session and making the school orchestra more interesting, as well as my fellow pianists, Isabel, Fortune, Osas, Osaritin, Divine, and Yembe. Before I finish my speech, as much as there were times that were really joyous, there were also times where I was struggling to keep up with the tension and anxiety of IGCSE examinations and other courses. But whenever I was down, whenever I felt depressed, whenever I was probably enraged or disappointed, my lovely and delightful juniors and friends were always there to support me. I'd like to thank Jason, Samuel, Tammy, Hans, Fortune, Isabel, William, Oche, Divine, Lashmi, Tito, Steven, Daniela, Ahmad, Priye, Dazi, Gabriella, Marvel, Tenyola, Gerard, Abdul, Shumaye, Iwe, my fellow Liverpool supporters, and other schoolmates for helping me during my time in NIS. Thank you, NIS, for being a wonderful family to me and my fellow classmates. As we graduate today, we are beginning to unlock the right path towards our future. As we graduate today, we leave a legacy for others to follow. As we graduate today, all eyes will be on the great, on the
on the great set after us. And in the end, only the ones who are well prepared will finish the long enduring race. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. That sounds like the speech of a professor. And he has taken his time to greet everybody in this school. So students, don't feel bad that Oyore has sent the greetings to all of you. And they are saying that they are going to miss you. Thank you, Ore. Thank you, class of 2021. I'll call on my second, Ms. Tinu, to come and continue the occasion.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Obi. We'll be taking a quick trip down memory lane now as the multimedia department will play us a video of the progress of each of our graduates today, right from the cradle till this day. Do enjoy it.
I close my eyes and I can see a world that's waiting up for me, that I call my own. Through the dark, through the door, through where no one's been before, but it feels like home. They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say I've lost my mind. I don't care if they call me crazy. We can live in a world that we desire. From far away, special things I compile, each one there to make you smile on a rainy day. They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say we've lost our minds. I don't care if they call us crazy. Run away to a world that we desire. Take away. I think of one.
Thank you. We now want to give them some presentations. We'll have them receive their stools and certificates, and then the principal and the chairman board of governors would be giving them some gifts. So we would be inviting the students on stage. We'd like you to come on stage. All of you, you can just move in that order. Come on stage while I call on Mr. Gill, principal of the school, and the chairman, board of governors, Dr. Mrs. Udensi. Please, let's put our hands together for them as they present certificate and gift to our graduating students. That's a presentation to Mr. Chimdi. That's a certificate from Norwegian International School. Let's put our hands together for them. What you admire, you attract. So when they are giving those certificates to them, please clap for them, especially students, so that your turn will come. Certificate to Jemima Gill. That is the decoration. Please put your hands together for Jemima. Iduvi Ogene, receiving his certificate from Norwegian International School. And then we have the decoration by no other person than the chairman of NISBOG, Dr. Mrs. Udensi. Please put your hands together for them. We are not clapping. When you get here, you'll understand why you need to clap. Amina Ahmed. You are hereby decorated. Put your hands together. Oreoluwa Oyetunde, receiving his certificate, class of 2021, we hereby decorate you. Put your hands together for this wonderful show. You're not clapping enough. Thank you. Thank you. Please stand for your pictures. Okay, after now they'll receive their gift. They have a hoodie from the chairman board of governors. It's a parting gift to this class.
with NIS logo on it. It will be a memorial. And then they will have a special gift from Mr. Gill. Okay, so let's have them. Okay, so this special hoodie is from the chairman, BOG. She's showing her appreciation to the commitment and resilience displayed by these wonderful students. Them receive their gifts, special gifts. Please keep this in remembrance of NIS. We love you, we care about you. As you go to Canada, UK, America, and all the cold places, use this to remember NIS. Take a picture now with the chairman, just the students and their mother in NIS. Students and mother in NIS. Yes, put your hands together for them. It's lovely. It's wonderful. You're not clapping. I hope nobody attempted to run out of the hall. That beautiful display of fireworks you just witnessed, it's Mrs. D.I.'s way of saying, I love these children. That was from Mrs. D.I., the former PTA chairperson of NIS. She's showing her appreciation. Lighting the fire for us. Okay, this is a principal's gift, something to remember. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. Next, we have Jemima and Chimdi, head boy and head girl, or outgoing head boy and head girl of NIS, do a presentation to be accompanied by Kazi and Mr. Nee. Happy viewing. Please, let's have them come on stage. Let's.
Are you guys ready to get funky with the class of 2021? Okay, let's get it.
Okay, we are gradually coming to an end. We are getting ready to cut the NIS 2021 cake. This is one thing I don't know how to do very well, cutting of cakes. But what I know is I know how to eat cake. But how to cut it is my problem. So I'll call on Miss Tinu. Please come and help us cut the cake. And later you can give me my piece. We would like to call on the parents of the graduating students. Head of admin and business manager, Mrs. Sabali. The principal, Mrs. D.I., Mrs. Dingpa, and the chairman, Board of Governors, to come cut the 2021 NIS cake. Please, let's come to
all right, please, it's time to cut the cake. Can we have the graduates first? You can
move towards your cake now. And parents of the graduating students, you can come out, please. Because if we leave that cake, Mr. Obi can carry it now. So I will invite you to come forward. Let's have the cake cut in. Chairman Board of Governors, Dr. Mrs. Udensing. Mrs. D.I., PTA Chairman, Mrs. Dingpa. And also, PTA Executives present, please. Mrs. Nwafo. Mrs. Oliver. Please join us in the cake cutting. Also, management, secondary school coordinator, please join us, Mr. Chooks.
Okay, yeah, 11 teachers, please come. Thereafter, we have only the parents of the graduating class, only the parents to come snap with them. 11 teachers.
Mr. Ifeanyi, Mr. Anthony, Mr. Ubi, Mr. Ben, Mr. Monsieur Cho, Miss Ifeanyi. Mr. Maxwell. Mr. Ernest. Okay, right after this, we'll be having a presentation of gifts to the year 11 teachers by the year 11 parents. I'll be inviting Mrs. Chidia Bali and Mrs. Oyetunde to do this presentation. Graduates, please stay back. You'll be taking pictures with the graduating parents. Teachers, please climb up stage. The parents have a presentation for you. Mr. Anthony, Mr. Teachers, please climb up. We have a presentation. Thank you.
afternoon, Board of Governors. Good afternoon, NIS community. We want to say a big thank you to our year 11 teachers. It's been a tough year, and we're not saying that all the other teachers didn't do wonderfully well. You all contributed to the success of these children. So we want to especially thank them for the S2 classes, S2 tutorials, S2 time, and everything they did to make today a success.
Yeah, would like to say thank you once again to all our beautiful teachers for making NIS a family and a home for the children. I could tell you that the children are always excited to come to school and attend their classes. We'd like to say thank you and keep on keeping on. Please don't stop. We appreciate you. Thank you very much and remain blessed.
Okay, now we'll be calling on the lady who wears two hats today. She's a mother to one of our graduating students, and she also happens to be the business manager here at NIS. Please join me as I welcome Mrs. Chidia Bali to give the vote of thanks and closing remarks. Thank you.
It's been an awesome day. It's a day we've been looking forward to. As NIS, this is a day we've been looking forward to, especially for this particular class. We want to say thank you to our students for the beautiful songs, wonderful performance, being present, not missing out. Some people would have said today we won't come to school. Thank you for being there. Without our students, it wouldn't have been wonderful. I want to thank our parents for your continuous support. If not for your support, I'm sure this would not have turned out like this. To our Board of Governors, we say thank you. To the management team of NIS, we don't know what to say. We say thank you. We parents of present years, 11 outgoing year 11 students, graduates now, want to say thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you for making this a success. For the teachers, we are really so happy. You people are exceptional. We appreciate you, we love you, and we say continue the good work. Thank you very much. Yeah, yeah. We believe us, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions, be truth seekers, be students, be teachers, be politicians, be preachers, preachers. Be believers, be leaders. Thank you very much. Can we please clap for my business manager again? Thank you. Thank you so much. All right. And this wonderful program, this gracious event has come to a close. We'll be taking the school song right now, and I'll be calling on Chikamara Unjoku to lead us in the school song. May we please rise as we take the school song together.
The place where
Thank you, Chikamara. Please, we would leave the hall in an orderly manner. Students, you go back to the school building. The parents will go out for family pictures with their children. In the next 15 minutes, we'll be back in the hall for the reception. When you come back to the hall, families are going to sit on tables. You'll be assigned tables. So when we come back, it's going to be very orderly. The teachers, you have your table. The families will have their tables for the reception. So we'll go out now. And the people that will leave first will be our graduating students. They will, music, you give us some, okay, the people here, you give us some music so that they will walk out. And when they leave the hall, they'll be followed by parents before students. So students, you remain on your seat. When the graduating students are gone, we'll have parents follow them before you leave. Thank you. We have come to the end of graduation ceremony of class of 2021 Norwegian International School. Please put your hands together for yourself, for being patient, for behaving yourself. Students, clap for yourself. You behaved well today. Thank you for coming, our parents. Thank you, our special guests, and all the people who could make this occasion. We are happy that you came. Thank you. Parents, you are now free to leave. Go take pictures, 15 minutes, please, so that we'll come back to the hall for the reception.